might be late. Been to this place before. It was a long time ago. We can fish down there.
Is the Murray or the Goulburn?
This is the Goulburn River. Someone had a bloody big fire in there. Use this one here for cooking. I suppose.
Huh?
I used that one for cooking. Hey?
What's around here, mate?
This wood there. Yeah. What about there?
Huh?
There.
That's not fucking wood.
That little piece there. Plenty of wood here. All that wood there, look at it all. Look at all the wood there, look at it all. All the barks,
all the bark and wood.
Fucking burning wood, that's shit wood. That's fucking
burnt.
The bark, Will. Feels pretty warm in that sun.
Funny
is. Pretty warm in the sun. See how that goes.
What do you got for bait?
Hot dogs.
Yeah,
that's where they come from.
Can't fucking reach on it. Stainless steel folding barbecue grill.
Get that one in the little one.
I reckon the medium.
Medium.
It's only 10:27.
Tomorrow is? 10:30. It's 10:30. Have an early lunch.
Early lunch, mate.
Breaking. Oh, God, these flies are shocking.
Brunch, mate.
I got a snag.
Yeah, for what?
Ah, I didn't lose anything. Only my bait.
Only your bait.
There's a strong current in this river.
Hey?
A strong current.
Yeah, it is. The rivers, they're letting water out of depth lock, I reckon, and the Hume. Rivers come up fucking 8 metres. Last couple of weeks, week and
what
half.
What the hell for?
It's a size 4.
What'd they do that for?
I think they're expecting a bit of water coming. The Hume was full, depth lock was full. I don't want to flood again, you know. So if we get a few days of rain, there's nowhere for it to go. So they let it out while they can. Been doing crazy shit, the river.
I got a snag.
Yeah, for what?
I didn't lose anything. Only my bait. There's a strong current in this river.
Aye.
A strong current.
Yeah, it is. The rivers, they let water out of the epilock, I reckon, and the Hume. Rivers come up fucking 8 metres. Last couple of weeks, week and a half.
What the hell for?
It was a size 4.
What'd they do that for?
I think they're expecting a bit of water coming. The Hume was full, the epilock was full. And I don't want to flood again, you know. So if we get a few days of rain, there's nowhere for it to go. So they let it out while they can. Been doing crazy shit, the river.
Crazy shit.
Good cast.
Grandfather come back to him and say, look, sorry boss, it's technically impossible without a massive upgrade of our power system. Bowen even had a plan to spend nearly $2 million to help invent a new renewable fuel for aeroplanes, again to cut emissions.
We know the opportunities are enormous for Australia and New Zealand to be key parts of the supply chain for sustainable aviation fuel across not just our region, but the world.
But on that very same day, Air New Zealand said it was actually dropping its emissions targets because the fuel
1104.
Just cost too much.
No bites.
This is a spectacular record of failure. And you have to ask,
what does this bloke have to do to lose his job?
And it's not okay. Someone's got to call it out.
How can someone so incompetent, so blinded by his green ideology, with a record of unadulterated failure virtually, be in charge of our power supply?
It's not okay to question conspiracy theories.
Why? Destroying a coal-fired power system that works with dodgy schemes. Green hydrogen that simply are not working. Bowen has to be fired before he kills this economy.
In my very strong view.
G'day, welcome to MGuy EV News for Sunday, the 6th of October, 2024. Be sure to follow me on the usual socials for more content, links in the description. And please make sure you're subscribed and have enabled all notifications so you don't miss out on any future videos. And of course, if you'd like to support this channel, why not buy me a coffee? Click the link in the description or scan the QR code on screen. So another EV News video this weekend. I know we only put one out yesterday, but so many stories have come in thanks to my wonderful emailers who send me all the stories. Thank you so much for that, as always. We got so much to get through. Again, it's going to be a... and hopefully you will enjoy that. So let's get going. So a great article in the UK Spectator about real life experience with EVs, and they're always bad. Nobody ever has an EV and says, oh, it's wonderful, it's so much better than an internal combustion engine car. Like, nobody says that ever. And this article is just another example of this. My electric car will be the death of me. Why can't it cope with cold weather? Great cartoon. Ask my friends and family and they'll tell you I am an electric car born. I'm not a gushing enthusiast. I'm more the negative kind of EV dullard. I can't stop telling people about the horror of driving these wretched things. I'm really not like this about other subjects or indeed about life. I'm generally pretty positive and optimistic, but I have an EV. I rely on it to get me from A to B at all hours in all weather conditions, and perhaps, heaven forbid, even at short notice. You might not be surprised to hear that my electric car is sorely deficient in doing all these things. I'll just quote a couple of extracts here. Fast forward to the present, and I no longer commute to Wolverhampton. Now, mirabile dictu, marvellous to relate, I travel around Europe fairly often. This also means regular trips in the electric, but mostly just to and from the airport, which is about an hour and a half's drive. The return leg is what I did last night. I landed late, got into my car with that familiar mix of trepidation and frozen breath, and paused for a moment before daring to look at the range displayed on the screen. Did I leave enough in the tank to get home in one go? Or would I have to stop to charge in some dark and lonely corner of a trading estate? The car told me that I had about 30 miles more than needed. I could relax, put on a podcast, and cruise on home. Or at least, that would have been the case had it not been cold, which it was. And if there wasn't a diversion, which there was. There were no more charges for the 50 miles of the remaining...
Hamburgers for lunch.
Beautiful. No onions.
Right.
I've got the onions today too. Have to go to Melbourne on the weekend. What a kind of joint that is.
Like protesters down there.
Yeah. I didn't see them, but fucking roads are terrible. I didn't do the tolls on the way down. Fuck that. It took me 4.5 hours. I did the tolls on the way back, took me 3. Yourself today, mate.
Huh?
You're looking after yourself today.
Just finished lunch. Now I check my rod. Go away. Hot dog still on there.
Yeah.
I've never caught a fish here actually. seen a tug on my fishing rod here. Bloody weed. Just a bit of weed. I thought I had... Hey? I thought I was. Oh, these flies are annoying. Nah. They're not bite.
Give the bait away, mate. Done fishing?
I'm finished for today. Thank you.